Hello, brethren. It's just me again. I had an idea that I wanted to put before you folks. And the idea is that with this imminent that we would be, you know, that we will be going with the Lord, we all have talked about that there will be a lot of conjecture and speculation as to what we, you know, what happened to those of us that have vanished and went with the Lord. What to them just seems like a mass disappearance. We have an option. We could write a letter that says what happened to us with, you know, like in my case, if when I disappear, then someone, you know, going through my pockets and, you know, trying to figure out what's going on, that they could find this letter, and in my own words, I could, you know, I could leave a testimony as to what it was that happened, where I went and what it's all about, you know. It is an idea that I think is worth pursuing, and I went ahead and wrote up a letter that I intend to print out and carry on my person. I don't intend to show it to anybody as far as it goes. It's not really anything that's going to have any effect until the Lord has taken me. And then at that point, you know, then when those questions arise, this will give me a voice to explain to folks what happened. Now, whether or not they believe it, that's up to them. But anyway, this is what I wrote. Being a singer and songwriter and poet, I wrote a poem at the beginning of my letter. But anyway, this is the content of my letter itself. It says, "To whom it may concern, if my disappearance seems unexpected, I place this note to be detected in my effects where they're collected and an explanation is sought. Though all this seems extraordinary, the truth is hope I've come to carry. By faith within is also very real, as I was taught. Jesus Christ, who died for all, has drawn me out with his sweet call. No reason here on earth to stall when he wants me at home. I've left behind the chains of time for love in his arms, peace sublime. No wrong was done, nor any crime, so let the truth be known." Well, that's in my stumble-bum way of talking, but anyway. Okay, here's what I've written after the poem. "I have been expecting my beloved Lord and Savior, Jesus of Nazareth, the resurrected Messiah, to pass by this planet in order to draw out those watching for him. If you are finding this in the wake of a massive worldwide event of simultaneous vanishings, speculation will certainly follow. Let this express my final testimony that Jesus has raptured his beloved bride according to his promise in the Bible. I was not abducted by anyone or anything. I willingly rose to meet him in the air, transformed by his Holy Spirit into an eternal form like my Lord, and covered with light as I was lifted up into his presence. When he had gathered all of us who responded to his call, he then took us to our new home in heaven to present us to his Father. This is what happened, and I wanted you to know. According to the scriptures, things here are going to get very bad very fast. Few will survive the 7-year period that follows without losing their identity at some point. In the century past, world war was a concept made real not once, but twice. In thousands of years of prior human history, it had never happened before, but 2012 marks 100 years since the first one began. A second one endeavored to eradicate the children of Israel and led to the recreation of a geographical Jewish state. A third is prophesied in Ezekiel 38, a failed attempt to overrun and destroy Israel outright that will result in a 7-year peace treaty with her neighbors. The treaty kicks off an unprecedented period of open cosmic conflict on the Earth, where evil seeks total dominion. War will be waged on all professing Jesus Christ as Lord, then on the descendants of Israel, as humanity is marked and subtly transformed into something else. It doesn't end until these demons in human guise surround Jerusalem and all but destroy it. When its defenders call on the Lord their God, Jesus himself will come to their rescue, accompanied by all of us who formerly disappeared when we went with him. Your choices in life are largely the same as they always were, though you now have less time to make them. Life was never certain, but will soon swing absurdly from stability to insecurity. The only thing we really control are the choices we make, the most important being whose will we will serve. Only God's will is eternal, and he preserves those who serve him in Christ Jesus. Everyone else self-destructs because he deserts the source of life, his creator. The perishing have no desire to perish alone and pull others down with them. It's the way of the world. Jesus suffered and died to reconcile sinners to God. Though you may die, he has promised those who repent and trust in him that he will raise them up to live again at the last day. Reference John 6:40 and 44. Life will be restored, life that is not subject to tragedy and suffering, life that is completely fulfilling and never ends. It's a pure hope in times that seem totally hopeless. Take hold of God's promises in the Bible and put them to the test. He never fails to prove his word is true and show the depth of his love for you. But the time to find out for yourself is now. Do not fear him who can kill the body and do no more, but rather fear him who, after the body is dead, hath power to cast the soul into hell. Yes, I say unto you, fear him. Luke 12:4-5. May the Lord who took me home be made known to you and give you peace. And I signed off, his by grace, and put a blank down here with under it, in parentheses, my name and signature. I intend to put this letter to attach it to this video. If I can figure out how to do it, I think I can. And anybody that wants to print it out can print it out and sign it and put their name on it. If it doesn't suit you, you have my permission to change this letter for your own purposes, for yourself, not to publish it online, but for yourself. If it totally doesn't suit you, then by all means, write your own letter, fold it up, put it on your person, and carry it. It's not to be shown to anybody. It's just a witness when you aren't here to bear witness yourself. And being that you are gone, and being more or less what folks consider to be your final words, I would think that they would carry some weight. It just seems like a really good idea to me. But God bless, and if we don't talk again between now and that time, then I hope to see you in the air. We love you. God bless. Bye-bye.